afternoon to Prof. Duncan Crate. And in the very beginning, I would like to thank your time for accepting our invitations to have a short interview with luminaries with Control Relay Societies for Young Scientists Committee. So in this short interview, as a young scientist, we like to know that what makes you think that you end up in the drug delivery?
Okay, well, I'm a pharmacist by original training. I appreciate that many people working in drug delivery come from all sorts of different backgrounds, but my own background was such that drug delivery was actually a very logical place to go with a pharmacy training because it brought together so many of your skills. And I think this is still one of the attractions of the field, that it inherently works across different disciplines, irrespective of what your first degree is. So that's something that I enjoy, and I suspect that most people working in the field would also say that it's something that attracts them to it.
All right, interesting. So further on to the next question, we want to know that what is your opinions on the current trends on the drug delivery, and what is the things that you think will be happening in the short future and the long future in drug delivery?
Okay. Probably because the field is so wide, anybody that you ask that question to will give you an answer which reflects their own activities and interests. So I'm personally very interested in nanofabrication and the interface between drug delivery, engineering, and then the clinical applicability. I'm not saying that is obviously the only area of interest going forward, but I think probably in a broader sense, I think there is very likely to be a great deal of interest in looking at not just drug delivery, but also manufacturing issues associated with biologicals. So for example, in the gene therapy area, there's growing interest in non-viral delivery because of the immunological concerns associated with using viral vectors. But also in terms of the biologicals, how is one going to manufacture these on anything resembling a larger scale? You could argue that's not really a drug delivery issue, but the thing is that these systems will need to have delivery vehicles of one sort or another, or at least a lot of them will. Mm-hmm. So probably that kind of interface between the biological, the delivery, and the realistic manufacture, I think is actually going to be a good growth area in the future.
All right, thank you very much for your insight. And the last one, as you know that we are a lot of young scientists getting into the drug delivery fields. So mm-hmm. What are your advice to the young scientists if they venture into this drug delivery?
Probably not to listen to people like me, because if young people are getting into drug delivery, they'll be changing it. Mm-hmm. But I think leaving that aside, I think the really exciting thing about the field is the interfaces with different disciplines. And when I started my career, all my grant applications had one or two names on them. Now, none of my grant applications or papers will have anything less than about four or five. And I think probably identify people that you feel that you can collaborate with, who have got skill bases which are complementary to yours, because nobody can hold all the different facets of what now constitutes drug delivery in their brain at the same time. So actually putting together teams is hugely important. And I think the other thing that I would recommend is don't forget to enjoy it as well. It's great to be ambitious, it's great to want to achieve really notable and impactful things, and I very much encourage that. But at the same time, it's incredibly fulfilling to be working with people that you like and respect, and to feel that you're finding things that are new and potentially valuable.
All right. Thank you very much for the very useful advice and comments. So we wish you that all the best for your career and continue contributing to the drug delivery. And we hope to see more and more exciting research from your group.
Okay. All right.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.